As an advanced medical practitioner and pharmacist practicing in family medicine, fertility and getting pregnant naturally is a very common question many patients ask me about. So whether you're starting your journey or you've been trying for a while, this video is here to give you clear, actionable tips to hopefully get you pregnant faster with scientifically supported, evidence-based information. So if you've been on my channel before, you'll know that I love to use an acronym. And for this video, I'm gonna use the LOVE method. So we're gonna work our way through the LOVE method and we're gonna begin with L. So your lifestyle is probably one of the most important foundations when you are trying to conceive. So a few months ago, I actually had a patient, they came in, they've been trying to conceive for a while and struggling. And one of the first questions I always like to ask patients is a bit about their lifestyle, taking a bit of history. And I soon came to realize they're living quite a stressful life. And also, as a result of all the work and all the commitments they have, they're having a lot of ready meals every day and hardly ever cooking food at home. So what did I suggest? I told them to start having more healthy whole food, start cooking at home more, have more fruit, more vegetables, start using actual lean protein sources. So just whole food, this is nothing complicated, just basically cooking nice fresh meals at home. And also whilst doing this, making sure that they're reducing processed sugars, too much red meat. Red meat is fine, but not having too much, and also reducing trans fats as well. And just by this one simple change in lifestyle, sometimes we miss these simple things basically. The patient was able to conceive and they've now got a beautiful baby girl on its way. Now in terms of supplements, there's one that I always recommend all females to take when trying to conceive, is a prenatal vitamin, nothing complicated, but make sure that it has 400 micrograms of folic acid in there and you take it daily. And there's lots of research and evidence out there that this folic acid has helped reduce significantly the rates of neural tube defects in babies. Also, whilst we're on the topic of lifestyle, remember, being healthy helps you get pregnant faster. So regular exercise and being at a healthy weight is important. BMI, I'd say more than 35, has been shown to take about twice as long to get pregnant. And by the way, the same applies for being underweight as well. So a BMI of less than 19 has been shown to be 4 times longer to get pregnant. So next up in our LOVE acronym, all right, we've done L, let's move on to O. So O stands for ovulation. I want to talk a bit about timing because there's always a lot of confusion about this with my patients. So to make this really simple, ovulation is where your ovary releases an egg. That egg only lives for about 24 hours. So we have a very short period when it can get fertilized. Now here's the thing that I want you to remember, sperm can survive and live inside the body for about 2 to 5 days. So when's the best time to have sex? Basically, start having sex 5 days before ovulation, because we know how long sperm can live for, and also on the day of ovulation. And just a fun fact, you're actually more likely to get pregnant on the 3rd day leading to ovulation. Just a fun fact for you to know. Now listen, every question is valid, so don't ever be concerned or think anyone's gonna judge you if you're asking, you know, certain questions. One question that I get asked often as well is, when is ovulation? Like, what is ovulation exactly? So just to make it simple, ovulation isn't during your period or right after it. So I'm gonna give you a working example. Let's say you have a regular cycle and let's say it lasts around 30 days. Here's a simple way to remember it. So your period is day number one and ovulation happens roughly 2 weeks before your next period. So 2 weeks is 14 days. And if we said we're having a 30-day cycle, so 30 minus 14, your ovulation will be around day 16. There are also many period tracking apps. There are also ovulation kits that you can get as well. So they can be very helpful too. So definitely look into them. And if your cycles are irregular or if it's just you're not getting it right, do speak to your medical provider about it. They're always happy to help with this kind of stuff. Next up, let's talk about maintaining a healthy vaginal and gut microbiome because it plays a big role in your overall well-being. And that's really where probiotics by Daye comes in. They're a simple, clean option made with just good bacteria and nothing else. Probiotics contains Lactobacillus plantarum GLP3. And this strain was originally extracted from fermented vegetables and grown in organic carrot juice. What I actually find really interesting is that they are completely free of additives. No dairy, soy, gluten, corn, or preservatives. And they're actually freeze-dried, not in a capsule. And lab tests show that they survive in both the gut and vaginal environment, which, by the way, isn't something you get with every probiotic out there. So if you're curious to learn more about Daye and their fantastic product range, I'd highly recommend heading over to their website and learning more. Link in the description below. Daye, thank you for being our trusted sponsor. Next letter in our love acronym is V. This stands for Vaginal Health and Sperm-Friendly Habits. So to tell you a bit about this one, I want to take it back to a patient I saw a long time ago. They were struggling to conceive, and when I'm taking lifestyle and learning more about their intercourse and all this kind of stuff, I came to realize that they're using quite common lubricants during their intercourse. Now, they were using things like KY jelly and even olive oil, but what they didn't know is that these kinds of lubricants can actually damage sperm. So what did I do? I advised them to stop using those lubricants and switch to a fertility friendly lubricant. And to be quite honest, not a lot of people know about this. In fact, some lubricants even have spermicidals in them as well. So I will leave some more information in the description about this as well. Now, in addition to this, remember, smoking reduces fertility for both men and women. It also increases miscarriage and preterm birth. Alcohol, one drink every other day, obviously having alcohol-free days is fine, but more than one drink a day, so 2-3 drinks a day, this can lead to infertility. And remember, I'm sure you know this, once pregnant, no alcohol is safe. With regards to caffeine, more than 4 or 5 cups a day can affect fertility. And during pregnancy, more than 2 cups of coffee a day can increase your risk of a miscarriage. So in terms of how much caffeine should you have, if you're trying to get pregnant and you're struggling to conceive, I would probably say try and avoid coffee and caffeine, basically. But if you really can't, you know, live without it, I'd say max it out at about 200 milligrams of caffeine a day. Think of each cup of coffee has about 100 milligrams of caffeine in it. Next, let's talk about marijuana. Women that use it are about 1.5 times more likely to have infertility. And men who use it generally have about a 30% lower sperm count. And by the way, this effect might be worsened if combined with cigarettes as well. And other harmful substances, dry cleaning chemicals, pesticides, heavy metals. Patients quite often ask me about sex positions, lubricants, orgasms, and frequency. In terms of position, no specific position helps more. You don't need to do anything crazy. You don't need to lay upside down for 15 minutes or anything like that. Sperm moves fast. It can reach the egg in about 2 to 15 minutes. In terms of orgasms, they're not needed to get pregnant. In terms of how often, I think this is a good question. For men, long gaps of 5 or more days between ejaculation can actually reduce sperm quality. So daily ejaculation for men is okay, particularly for those who might have a lower sperm count. So moving on to the last letter in love, and that is E, which is for emotional wellness and support. Look, trying to get pregnant can be emotional. There's the pressure, comparisons, and even the disappointment. So try and give yourself the permission to try and enjoy the journey. Try and let go of stress where you can. Practice yoga, meditation, go for a walk, anything that helps you feel more grounded. And if you're feeling overwhelmed, talk to your medical provider. They are there to help. Your emotional health matters just as much as your physical health. It's all connected. And it's hard to get pregnant. You know, if you're under 32, you've got a 20 to 25% chance of getting pregnant each month. At 35, it drops to about 12 to 15% each month. And it can actually vary if you've already had a baby before as well. And by 38, with no prior pregnancy, it drops to about 5% per month. But here's the good news. Most couples, around 80%, conceive within 6 months of trying. And by the way, it usually happens within the first 3 months, so the first 3 months of the 6 months. So if it's been 12 months of regular unprotected sex with no pregnancy, you should speak to your medical provider. Or it's been 6 months of trying and you're over 35. Also, we touched upon this a little earlier. Remember, speak to your medical provider if you have irregular periods or if you have any medical conditions. And by the way, I will leave loads more information in the description. Please do read it on when to seek medical advice. Let's also not forget male fertility as well. Fertility generally reduces quite drastically, about 40 to 45 years. If you're a smoker, you've got previous steroid use, as well as infections or injuries, all of these can affect the sperm quality. So I really do hope you found this information helpful. Good luck in your journey. If you know anyone who would also find this information helpful, please do share it with them. We do spend a lot of time finding evidence-based information to share with you guys. So I really appreciate you coming on the channel and giving our video a watch. As we always say at the end of every single week's video, thank you so much for watching and sending awesome vibes. So let's go back to the acronym, LOVE. Oh. position. You don't need to change. Oh my God, I cannot speak today on this video. How many cups of caffeine should you have? How many cups of caffeine should you have? Smoking reduces fertility. I've just gone completely blank.